Welcome to the screencast where I will show you how to add multiple backends to the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes. My name is Chris Snell and I am a technical marketing engineer for Hewlett Packard Enterprise Storage Division. Today I'll be talking about how the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes communicates to the backend storage arrays like HPE Primera, 3PAR, and HPE Nimble Storage, and how to manage arrays within a Kubernetes cluster. For many customers, connecting a single array to a Kubernetes cluster may be sufficient. But in some environments, customers need to request storage from multiple arrays from within a single cluster. This gives you ultimate control on managing the placement of your data to ensure it meets your application requirements. The HPE CSI driver can manage an individual Primera or Nimble array, or you can configure it to support multiple. The HPE CSI driver leverages Kubernetes secrets to manage communication to the storage backends or arrays. These secrets contain sensitive information like the array IP, credentials, and additional information used by the CSI driver. These secrets are then referenced within a storage class by various CSI sidecars to communicate to the provisioner and array. I will go through how to configure the secrets in storage class that will be used to communicate and provision persistent storage from my two Primera arrays. These steps are done after deploying the CSI driver using the Helm chart or operator. In this demo, I will be showing the steps using two Primera arrays, but the same steps can be used when setting up multiple 3PARs or Nimble arrays. So let's get on with this. Here I have a new Kubernetes cluster with a fresh install of the CSI driver that I did with the Helm chart. I can verify the CSI driver is installed by running helm list the namespace kubesystem-o YAML. With the CSI driver deployed, I will go ahead and create the default secret for my main Primera array. For help with this, you can find the guide to add additional backends to the CSI driver out on scod.hpedev.io, or SCOD for short. Under the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes in the left-hand menu, click on Deployment and then Adding Additional Backends. Here you can find information on how to inspect any existing secrets that may be within your cluster, as well as some examples of creating custom secrets in storage classes. As you scroll down, you'll be able to find the code block of YAML that I will be using as a basis to create my secret. Since I'm configuring the CSI driver to talk to a Primera array, I will use the code block labeled Primera. You can also find an example here for Nimble Storage. Let's switch back over to the terminal. Now I will go ahead and create the default secret. Like I mentioned before, secrets are meant to contain sensitive data, and the secrets for the CSI driver contain information like the array IP, the username and password. The secret will also define the namespace and the service that will be used to communicate with the backend arrays, which in my case is a Primera. In order to connect my secondary Primera to this cluster, I also need to create another secret in the same manner as I did with the first one. Again, I will define the array IP for my secondary Primera, as well as the username and password. Once I have the secrets defined, I can create them within Kubernetes using the kubectl create command. With the secrets created, I will now need to create a storage class for each of these arrays. Note, since the CSI sidecars within a storage class can only reference a single secret at a time, I will need to create a storage class per secret and array. I can find an example of this by switching back over to SCOD. If I scroll down a bit, I can find an example of a storage class. In this example, it's a pretty basic storage class that also contains the CSI sidecars that can be used. Since I have a Primera array, I will also need to go to the specific CSP pages to find these parameters that will be required for the Primera backend. In this case, a storage class for a Primera array also needs the CPG and provisioning type parameters. If you scroll down a little bit further, you'll find some additional parameters that are available to set within the storage class. Now let's switch back to the terminal. I will again go ahead and create the default storage class that I want to use. Here, I will define a name as well as set this storage class as default within the cluster. Here, you can also see the various CSI sidecars that need to be configured to use the default Primera secret I just created, along with the namespace. I will also add the CPG and provisioning type I want to use. Once that is complete, I will create the default storage class within the cluster, again using the kubectl create command. With that, I'll go ahead and create the storage class for the secondary array. It is the same process as before, but in this case, I won't set this storage class as default. Again, I'll specify the secret for each of these sidecars and make sure that it's set to that secondary Primera secret. And since this is another Primera, I'll go ahead and add the CPG and provisioning type parameters here as well. Once done here, I will create the secondary storage class within the cluster. With both of the storage classes now available, I can create a persistent volume claim against each of them. I will be creating some basic PVC requests where I request 20 gigs from the default storage class, as well as 40 gigs from the secondary storage class, which will in turn provision storage from both the arrays that I have configured. I'll define the PVCs as read-write once, since this is block storage, as well as make sure to reference the correct storage class. Once I'm done, I'll go ahead and create those PVCs within the cluster. Finally, we can verify that the PVCs were created and successfully bound to the cluster by using the kubectl get PVC command. Here, I can see that the volumes have been created and successfully bound. This also verifies that the CSI driver was able to communicate and provision volumes from both of my Primera arrays using the secrets and storage classes that I just created. With the PVCs bound and available to the cluster, I can now attach them to my application. This concludes the demo of managing multiple backends with the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes. If you're interested in learning more about HPE storage and the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes, visit hpe.com/storage/containers. See you next time.